You saw two teams deserving of their rankings, two of the best teams in the country, who went toe-to-toe. I have a lot of respect for UCLA. They had a couple opportunities to maybe quit, or, you know, it's just not how they are. I mean, you're talking about warriors on that team, Jordan Canada, Monique Billings, Kelly Hayes. Those three seniors have led that to be one of the greatest programs in the country. We're just fortunate we made a couple of stops in that overtime, and then Sabrina, you know, kind of put us on the back that last 5 minutes. But that was a heck of a win. I'm really proud of our team.
Really, you guys had a nice quick lead, and three to go up. Like, after, you guys could have recovered.
Yeah, we just kind of grinded and just hung on, really. I mean, that's the honest truth. We hung on. It was very similar to our Stanford game, where I just thought we lost some focus, we lost some intensity. And let's face it, Jordan Canada and Billings, that's an amazing and talented team. And especially Jordan, she just decided there's no way we're going to let this happen. And she just kind of took it upon herself, single-handedly wrecked our defense. And then others got involved, and Billy shot it well tonight. They started to hurt us on the boards, and it just kind of snowballed a little bit like we'd seen before. But it was really nice that that we did recover, and we took their blow, and, you know, we got back up off the mat, so to speak.
Kelly, you guys moved the ball really well, at least in the first half. Yeah. Was that a concerted effort to really move the ball side to side and open up the inside?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's, if you've seen us play, that's kind of how we play. I think we're one of the more efficient teams in the country offensively, and we're at our best when we move it around. And we kind of went again with our smaller lineup, and so we were able to really spread the defense out. That's when we were at our best. So, and then that gives Ruthie some driving opportunities and post up opportunities. Satu was making shots tonight, and it makes a huge difference. I thought for a freshman in this kind of an environment, she just showed what she's capable of doing, and had a great game.
She struggled the other night. Did you have to do anything to kind of rebuild her confidence the last couple of days, or just let her play through it?
No, you just let her play through it. You know, we try to build her up. One thing about Satu is she's hurt, and, you know, she doesn't practice much. And so she goes full contact for the first time in the games. And this week we actually had her kind of get pushed around a little bit in practice, and I think it prepared her more for this game.
Mike, they had 17 points in the first half. Kelly, you seem to have an answer every time you guys needed something. What can you say about her first half?
Man, I thought Maite was huge tonight. That is not easy going against the quickness of those guards. And guess what? She gets guarded 94 feet every possession. And, you know, it tires you out, wears you out. And she showed great resilience. I mean, I don't know, just about 17 in the first half, is that she ended up with? Hit him from the three, hit some layups, hit some free throws. I thought she was phenomenal, and a little nervous when she went down, but was able to come back in and help us finish the game. But we don't have a lot of upperclassmen. She's one of them, and that's what you expect from her.
Sabrina, what was your mentality going into overtime?
I mean, especially after missing that free throw, I knew I wasn't going to let my team down and our seniors down. I should have made it. But I think it tested us. We had to come back, you know, that 5 minutes and fight adversity and stay composed. And I think we did. We answered that test well. We gotta stay together and keep working hard and try to finish teams off in regulation.
Did you figure, though, they might have a run at them? I mean, they were going to start
kind of swinging
away once they were down.
We talked about it at halftime. We knew we were going to come out, and, you know, the score was going to be 0-0. It's a whole new half, and we knew that they were going to go on their runs. I mean, they have seniors and a lot of upperclassmen that don't want to lose. So we knew that they were going to come back and punch us, and we decided to be able to punch back and take it.
Ruthie, what's it like to get an ovation from this?
probably the first and last one I might ever get, so fine.
Ryan, it was good.
Can you just, now that it's over, put that streak in perspective?
I mean, it was a great streak. It was always fun to make a shot, so I'm really happy I could break that record, and I'm ready to start another one now.
What, how many did she make before she missed?
33.
So 33, the new standard. All right, kiddo. Good job.
Sabrina, that was probably the chippiest game I've seen you guys play this year. They were bumping you as much as they could every time you had the ball. Did you feel that for the entire game?
For sure. I mean, you know, they have fast athletic guards that try and try and get in and make it comfortable, and that's what we just have to take. And we adjusted to the refs calling fouls, but I mean, I went to the line 12 times, so they definitely called fouls, and we just had to adjust. We set the screens a little bit lower to give us some more room to attack and drive and try and free up Ruthie down low. But they're an aggressive team, and like we said, they didn't want to lose, and especially it was our senior night. It was one of the biggest games of the year that we've had. So they were coming out, and we knew that they were going to come out aggressive and try to get steals and get in passing lanes.
Kelly, I just want to reflect back on, but just looking ahead, going into next week with a lead, what does that feel like?
I haven't really thought about it. I'm just going to enjoy this one. This is a real sweet victory, you guys. An amazing crowd. Arguably, biggest game in Oregon women's basketball history. I mean, with the national TV audience, we were playing, you know, had a lot to play for in terms of potential NCAA seeding and a conference championship and two elite teams. And, you know, I'm just going to enjoy this tonight. I wish I drank. I already got a beer. But I don't, so I'll do my Diet Coke with this little lemon. And, it's funny, you look at improvements, and with Sabrina right here next to me, you know, the first time we played them, I think she had 6 or 7 turnovers, struggled a little bit. Tonight, you have 12 turnovers, no assists against that kind of pressure, and hitting the big shot she did down the stretch. That's what your All-Americans got to do, and she did it tonight.
You mean 12 assists and no turnovers?
Did I say 12 turnovers?
Yeah. That's what he expects.
I'm just conditioned to say
that. That's what he expects out of you.
12 assists, no turnovers. I'm really proud of you, and I'm really happy for our seniors. Justine Hall, who I've known since birth, and you know, she's a family friend and means so much to our team. And Lexi Bando, she was the first recruit that took a chance on us. You know, and we didn't have a whole lot to sell her other than a vision of what we could become, and she's helped us realize that. And I think those two have really left a heck of a legacy for us. So I'm happy for them. I'm really proud of them, and I'm proud of the Ducks tonight. That was a hell of a win.
That makes it a crazy night, a little lemon in the Diet Coke.
You know what? To change things up, I might go lime. Citrus is citrus. You know, and with my voice the way it is, I need a little bit right now. I maybe yelled a couple times. But anyway. That was a fun night, you guys.
Kelly, can you describe what the atmosphere was like in the building tonight? Is this the best you've seen it since you've been here?
No question. It was electric. And we needed them tonight. We needed them. I thought down the stretch they gave us a huge lift, especially defensively late in the game and into overtime. I heard them. There were a couple times I think sound actually had feel, a couple of times. And that's pretty neat. It's pretty neat. This was a great showcase, you guys, a great national showcase for our fans, our program, this team.
So, Kelly, forgive me, I know you want to sort of just marinate the moment, and I don't blame you, but if you can reflect back on a young team last year that was 8-10 and then got hot, played well in the tournament, carried that over, has this just been sort of a progression ever since then of what this group has done?
No doubt. 8-10 in conference last year, nobody saw that run coming, but I think it just gave us a ton of confidence, especially these two. And I've always felt that players improved the most between their freshman and sophomore years. They certainly did that. I think our offseason, our players were really focused. We worked harder, I think, than ever, because then they saw. And I'm glad we finished with Connecticut, because they're the standard by which every team's judged. And so I thought it was a perfect storm last year. And it just kind of helped propel us. And these guys, they don't play like there's really any pressure. I love it. They're so loose. You go to our shoot rounds, you go to our practices, they're pretty loose, they have fun. And right now we're 25-4 and compete against some of the best teams in the country. So I think today was our 15th game against top 50 opponent. And I believe our 11th win. Not many teams, if any, have played that many games against that kind of competition. So again, just super proud of this group. Take the day off tomorrow, and then Wednesday we'll worry about the next game. I don't even know who it is, but it's somewhere down in the desert, and we got more work to do. This game won't matter if we don't go down there and take care of business. So,
anything else?